Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Loaded TV Season 3. You already saw the first episode of Alex Colorado Adventuring Around Downtown. That is the first of the adventure series, but this week, this Monday, we are bringing you the first of the educational Loaded TV episodes. Every Monday at 12 p.m. PST, you can expect to see a Loaded TV episode come into your screen. So be sure to like this, subscribe, and make sure you enable notifications so you can see when these videos come in for your viewing pleasure. Today we're gonna be talking about longboard dancing. It is insanely popular once again, and we are very happy to see that because you can do it just about anywhere. Okay, possibly one of the most fundamentally important and necessary tricks to know is the cross step. The cross step can be used in tons of different variations, and it makes up pretty much like 50% of all longboard dancing tricks. All right, so the cross step is insanely simple. Remember, I'm goofy, ladies and gentlemen, so if you wanna learn this for a regular ride, just flip the video, watch the video in a mirror, yeah. Oh, there we go. Look, I'm regular for you, I think. Is that how videos work? You're gonna bring your front foot parallel to your back foot, right about here. You don't need them touching exactly or like super, super close. They could have a little bit of space. With my front foot coming right next to my back foot, I'm gonna take my back foot, cross it in front of the front foot. Boom, look at me. I'm all crossed up right now, but this is very unstable. So now we're going to put weight on the back foot, release the front foot, step with the front foot back into somewhat its original position, and then go back. Now, it's pretty important to have an even rhythm with this, because if you're kind of like doing each step a little off beat and almost randomly, it doesn't look that smooth, you know? You won't have that flowy feeling. So make sure that you go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the forward cross step, and of course, you can do it going backwards as well. It's where you come back like so. So now you're starting to play around with different variations in cross step. You could also do it switch. It's gonna be a little bit weirder on the balance, but over time you'll get better at it. The key to a good cross step is making sure that your head stays above your feet. If your head is slightly in front of your foot or leaning slightly behind your foot, you're gonna find yourself having a hard time maintaining your balance. If your upper body and your head are leaning back, you're gonna kind of tumble backwards. Now, it's really easy to just get the steps. You can do that over and over, but remember, longboard dancing is not just one dimension. It's not just forward and backwards. You wanna be moving side to side. How do you do that? By applying weight specifically to your heels or to your toes in order to do a toe side or a heel side cross step. You do your normal cross step, but try to lean on your heels when you do it, and then try to lean on your toes when you do it. As you're getting ready to go into your cross step and you're bringing your front foot next to your back foot, this is when you're gonna start initiating a turn in your most comfortable direction. Most of the time, it's gonna be heel side. And then as you return to your normal stance, maybe throw in a toe side carve. Remember, you could also do this exactly opposite. Bring your foot back, start leaning on your toes, cross step, go back to normal, and then heel side carve. What you get is that constant sidewinder carving, snowboarding looking sensation and feel. And you're actually flowing while you're dancing. It makes cross steps infinitely more enjoyable. Now, Peter Pans are another fundamental trick. With these and cross steps, you can start combining and making sick combos, super combo breaker. For the Peter Pan, you're gonna take that same front foot, you're gonna put it right in the middle of the board, equal distance from the trucks, but off to the side. See, my toes are here, so I place my foot on my toe side edge. Now I'm gonna release my back foot and balance solely on my front foot, boom, like so. And you're gonna kind of glide and then carve really hard on your toe side edge. Now for the Peter Pan to be the Peter Pan, you make your feet go parallel. This is where the cross comes back. And in this parallel position, you're gonna release your front foot. Bop, and now you're balancing on your left foot. My front leg is swinging out. I'm carving on my heel side edge, or to the right for me. And then I place my front foot in its original position and then go back. So all together, that looks like this, 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 this. And if you want to get fancy with it or a little Ari Chama's Manny style, you do the Peter Pan multiple times. Boom, boom, boom. Just like the cross step, you can do it going backwards. So I'm coming at you, but I'm deciding to look away because we've had an argument. all the steps are the same, except the balance is way weirder, you know, because you're going backwards and you can't see where you're going. Make sure you're in a big open area, you know? But now you're carving, looking at backwards, and you come back around, you're like, hey, what's up, mom? It's good to see you again. Like, I'm gonna do it this way. You know what? I don't like that time you grounded me, so I'm gonna turn back around, and I'm gonna do the Peter Pan this way. But I forgive you, so I came back and I'm looking at you again. Combine them. This is how you get the flow. Combine the moves.
Another trick, pretty easy. I would say this could be the easiest one, the 360 step. That's how we're gonna call it. What is it about? You step on your board and do a 360. So what you wanna do is start like a Peter Pan. You put your feet here, and then once you put weight, your body is gonna lean towards your toe side edge, just like the Peter Pan. But instead of like going here, start rotating your shoulders from the top, do a 180, all of a sudden you're going switch, and then you just keep rotating this foot to get it here. And this is the tricky part, because you're gonna be backwards for a moment. But you just like turn around, go on your hillside edge and back. It's very easy. You can do it on the other direction, which feels a lot more fun, where instead of like spinning this way, you can come and like spin this way. And then back. It's like carving left to right, but you're just spinning as you're doing. You know, you're carving left, go here, boom, you carve right, go straight. You can do that move into other moves. You can do like a cross step and cross, come here, boom. That was sick, and you look superstitious and you spin a lot. Another way is with a pirouette, which we're gonna show right now, where you can come here, get on this side, and all of a sudden you're like spinning and bah, and you pirouette. How do we do pirouettes? Let me tell you. So I'm going that way. I want to do a pirouette. Pirouettes can feel a little scary. I think we talked about them on a previous video, but we'll just give you a little tip. My trick for pirouettes, first of all, commit to it. It feels a little scary. You go slow, you fall, you're not gonna get hurt. So go for it. It's a motion that starts from the top and it transmits all the way to the bottom. You start rotating your shoulders and then you release your feet and do the spin. If you don't move your shoulders, you're not gonna do the 360. Get your feet somewhere in the front, like definitely not in the middle, definitely not in the tracks, something in between. Get it like straight, because if you're here, that's like a quarter spin more that your feet have to do, so you can cheat it. You can be here. You see my shoulders are forward and I'm looking at my back foot, because my back foot is gonna go out. All you have to tell your head is back foot goes back to that place. Don't stop looking at it and just do it. Like, I'm here, I'm looking at it, I'm releasing, and I'm still looking at it. You wanna do a turn on your lumbar, you definitely wanna look where you're going to. Same thing. You're here, you look, start spinning, release, up, and down. It'll take you a few tries, but if you fully commit to it, it's one of the most pleasant dancing moves, in my opinion. It's one of the most fun to do. Yeah, remember to keep the flow. You can connect everything. It's pretty fun. And find your own rhythm. Don't try to skate like someone. try to find your own rhythm. You seem pretty ready to go dance, but before you go out there, there's like a few tips that I think are pretty important to keep in mind. The first one is, all these things we taught you, don't look at them as tricks. Don't think a cross step is a trick and it's like, damn, I got this cross step bolts. No. Don't think about it as a trick. There's steps. It's a continuous flow of movements where nothing itself has a value above everything. There's a momentum going. Keep that rhythm going. Try to connect. Try to not stop. I hope that makes sense.
All right, guys, so that's the end of the first educational video of Loaded TV Season 3. We hope you enjoyed it. We only have a lavalier with us, so we're gonna just pass this mic back and forth. But we appreciate your feedback, so please leave something in the comments. Let us know whether you liked the video or if you want us to do another style of skating.
And if you think we left something behind, it'll be pretty useful if you put it in the comments so other people can learn from everybody's knowledge. Let's make this a forum. Let's start a conversation. Anyways, thanks for supporting, thanks for watching and being stoked about Loaded TV.
Well, so please leave a comment down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe and enable those notifications if you want to keep seeing Loaded TV episodes. Remember, 12 p.m. PST, that is when the episodes come out. Next week will be an adventure video, but then the week after that will be another instructional one. So let us know what you want to see and we will try and do it. No, we will do it.
No, we do read the comments. We take very seriously your feedback. So
and we visit your home address, only sometimes. I'm looking at you, Dave.
You shouldn't say that, man. That's not like we have to reshoot the whole episode.
Oh, we'll be outside your house tonight.